Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I will describe how to perform janaza prayer very briefly. First of all, I would like to say, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that salatul janaza is very, very important and very virtuous. I appeal to every single one of you not to miss Salatul Janaza under any circumstance. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam says, "Man salla ala janazatin falahu qirat." The one who performs Salatul Janaza, he will have one karat. What is the karat? The karat is, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, like the mountain of Uhud. Subhanallah, the mountain of Uhud. Uhud is a huge mountain in Medina area. It is more than 10 miles by 4 miles. Just by praying what? By praying janazah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, and the one who follows the janazah until it is buried, he will have two karats. Subhanallah. Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he heard this hadith, he verified that it is an authentic hadith, and he was weeping because he missed so many opportunities of janazah. Moreover, my dear respected brothers and sisters, the deceased will benefit from your salah. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, actually there are three different statements from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam concerning the benefit for the deceased from your janazah prayer. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if an ummah of people pray or offer janazah prayer on a person, they will intercede for him on the day of resurrection or in the other. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, their number will be in a way that they will be divided into three lines. And that's why the companion who reported this hadith, he used to like that they line three different lines to pray janazah. This is one thing. So it is highly recommended to gather a big amount of people to offer the janazah prayer. This is one thing. And when they come together, it is highly recommended as well, my dear respected brothers and sisters, to divide yourselves into three different lines. Subhanallah. My dear respected brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, if you offer the janazah prayer, then akhlisu lahu du'a, then make sincere du'a, because this is the essence of salatul janazah. Salatul janazah is very simple. Don't worry about so many things. And there are variety of ways of performing janazah. And look, Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, one time he was not on wudu and the janazah came and the salah was about to start. The janazah prayer was about to start. He knew that if he were to go and perform full wudu, he wouldn't be able to catch salatul janazah. He performed tayammum in order to offer the janazah prayer. So there is flexibility, my dear respected brothers and sisters, in terms of salatul janazah. Even if you don't know it, then offer any kind of dua on the mayyit, join the congregation and just do whatever they do. Insha'Allah, it will be counted as Salat al-Janazah for you. Now, Salat al-Janazah in a standing position. Now, the Imam will stand behind the janazah. Don't worry much about the position of the Imam. There is a flexibility in that. Don't worry about the right position of the janazah. There is some flexibility in that. There are different views by different madhahib. The key thing is offer Salat al-Janazah. The Imam will stand either to the middle of the deceased, whether male or female, or next to the, or opposite to the head of the deceased, male or female, different views by different scholars. Inshallah, all opinions are valid. You pray behind the Imam, even if you line with the Imam because of space or because of necessity, there is no problem. You line behind the Imam and in a standing position, you will say Allahu Akbar, you will raise your hands. That is not even a big issue. The key thing is you intend to pray the janazah and you say Allahu Akbar. And then after the first takbirah, there are two views. Either you read Surah Al-Fatiha, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, or Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, or you make dua al-istiftah according to the Hanafi opinion and the Maliki opinion as well. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdika, tabaraka ismuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruka, or even according to some views, you say any kind of opening dua. And then after that, you say Allahu Akbar. Don't worry about raising your hand or not raising your hand. This is not the issue. The key issue is most of the madhahib, they say after the second takbir in a standing position, what you say is the Darood Sharif. Now there is a full form of the Darood Sharif and there is a short form. Don't worry about that. Just say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. If you don't memorize this, say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Say that at least in Arabic. And even you can complete in English. Even if you do not memorize that in Arabic, just say it in English, and that is not a problem, inshallah. Then you say Allahu Akbar again in a standing position, and this is the key element of Salat al-Janaza, and then you make dua for the deceased. There are different forms of dua. Don't worry about them if you do not memorize them. If you memorize them, that then alhamdulillah, then this video is not for you. But if you do not memorize them, just make any dua that Allah Jalla Ala forgives the deceased. This is the key thing. As we said that the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that this is the essence of Salat al-Janaza, that you make dua for the deceased. What kind of dua? Even if you do not know what kind of dua you do, you say, oh Allah, forgive him. Oh Allah, forgive him. Oh Allah, make him firm when he is questioned by the angels in his grave. Oh Allah, make his grave as part of paradise. And oh Allah, don't make his grave as part of hellfire. Oh Allah, if he was a good person, then increase his reward. Even if he was a sinful person, oh Allah, you are the one who forgives, wipe out all of his sins. And you can also make dua for the other deceased, and you can make dua for your deceased, and you can make dua for all Muslims, whether they are attending the janazah or whether they are not attending the janazah. The key thing is, oh Allah, forgive him. Ya Allah, forgive him. Oh Allah, we beg you to forgive him. And he will benefit from your dua, especially if your dua is sincere. Then in a standing position, you say Allahu Akbar, following the Imam, of course. When the Imam says Allahu Akbar, say Allahu Akbar. Don't worry again about raising your hand or not raising your hand. This is a very, very minor issue. Then the Imam will pause for a few seconds, and then the Imam either will do taslim, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, from both sides, right and left, or he will make the taslim from one side, the Hanabila. The Hanabila, they believe that there are two taslim, the Hanabila and Malikiya, but the Hanafis and Shafi'is, they believe that it is two taslim. Sorry, the Hanabila, they believe that it is one taslim, and the Shafi'is and the Hanafis believe that it is two taslim. Don't worry about that. Just follow what the Imam is doing. Both opinions are valid, and then that's it. And see, brothers and sisters, it's very simple, straightforward. Just do it. And as we said, just make Salat al-Janaza. Don't miss it. May Allah Jalla wa Ala forgive the sins of all of our deceased. My dear respected brothers and sisters, even if you miss Salat al-Janaza, you want to do Salat al-Janaza in abstinia, you can do it. Don't worry. Some scholars say that, no, don't do it. Just do it, inshallah. Even if you can't do that, just make sure that you make dua for the deceased. My dear respected brothers and sisters, your father, your mother who passed away, your relatives, they are in a small, tiny room. Allahu A'lam. And subhanAllah, please do remember this. When you say, oh Allah, forgive my father. Oh Allah, make the grave of my father as part of Jannah. At that moment, Allah Jalla Ala will accept your dua. And imagine this. Allah Jalla Ala will expand the grave of your father. He will be in a desperate need for just this statement. Oh Allah, forgive my father. Forgive the sins of my father. Oh Allah, make the grave of my father as part of the Jannah. Your father will be so pleased with your dua. He will be waiting for your dua. And this is the best kindness to the parents whom Allah Jalla wa'ala commanded us to be kind to them. We might be kind to them in this life, but we forget them in once they die. No, no, no. Whenever you see a dead person, whenever you remember your father, whenever you go to your house, remember to make dua for those deceased. They will be so happy and desperate for your dua. And imagine, as I said, their grave at that moment will be made as part of Jannah. La ilaha illallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.